Hi, I'm Tony Foster, a Senior Principal Engineering Technologist with Dell Technologies. In this video, we will demonstrate the steps necessary to upgrade a PowerFlex environment from PowerFlex 3.6.2 to PowerFlex 4.5. This is the third and final video in the PowerFlex 3.6 to 4.5 upgrade series, and covers the task to update storage-only nodes and HCI clusters to PowerFlex 4.5. In the previous videos, we covered the steps needed prior to updating PowerFlex workload clusters and how to update workload clusters. You can find the links to the previous two videos in the notes below. Before beginning the PowerFlex workload cluster update, there are some important things to cover. Please refer to the previous video for the procedures to update the PowerFlex management cluster to 4.5. This video is for illustrative purposes only. Many parts of it have been accelerated to fit the time allotted. It is assumed that a new PowerFlex 4.5 management platform, PFMP, has already been deployed in the environment and the management environment has already been migrated to it. Deploying a new PFMP is beyond the scope of this video. This video assumes the necessary RCM packages have been downloaded from a Dell Digital Locker. The video also assumes familiarity with basic PowerFlex management operations. As with any maintenance operations, users are strongly encouraged to create a backup of their existing environment prior to attempting an upgrade. Advanced upgrade procedures are not covered in this video and should be directed to Dell technical support. Please contact your Dell technical support representative for questions about the upgrade procedure. With that, let's get started. We will start in the resource groups, which is accessible from the lifecycle menu. We will start by working with the storage only or SO resource group. We can open the resource group by clicking on its name. If we scroll down, we can see that physical nodes for the resource group show as non-compliant. We can click on Non-Compliant in the Resource Group Information box at the top of the page. From the Node Compliance Report, we will select the storage nodes from the list. We can also look at the software components, at which point we click the Update Resource button in the lower right corner. We then review the update settings, selecting the appropriate maintenance mode operations. Then we click on the Apply button. We confirm that we wish to upgrade the storage nodes by clicking Yes. We then wait for the update to finish, noting that the update may take up to 2 hours per node to complete. The recent activity will show that the update job completed successfully. When the upgrade is finished, click on Resource Groups at the top left of the screen. This shows the resource group as compliant. Now, click on the resource group name. From here, we can see that the SO nodes show as compliant. Now we will update the HCI resource group. In our VMware vCenter, we see an HCI cluster with 4 nodes, .36 to .39. These are the nodes we will update. In the PowerFlex Manager, we click on the name of our HCI resource group. This will display the resource group details. When we scroll down, we can see 4 nodes are non-compliant. If we scroll up and click Non-Compliant for the resource group, on the right-hand side of the screen, we can see the Node Compliance Report. From the report, select the HCI nodes to be updated, then click Update Resources. Review how the resources will be updated. In this case, we will select Instant Maintenance Mode and click the Apply button. At this point, we will wait for the update to complete. The recent activity shows that the updates completed successfully. Note that Compute still shows as non-compliant. This is because, as we have shown earlier, the vCenter is non-compliant. To ensure the inventory is up to date, we will go to the Resources menu, select All Resources, and click the Run Inventory button. Again, we check the resource groups under the Lifecycle menu. When we look at the HCI resource group, we see that the state is unchanged. This concludes upgrading an environment from PowerFlex 3.6 to 4.5. You can visit Dell.com to learn more.